I was having y'all, it's your boy Rico from Street Scores coming with a quick report. I want to talk about Chase Roullier being re-signed to a four-year contract extension. I'm going to break down all of his contract details and why he was well worth the money we're giving him. And then also I want to talk about some of the other Burgundy and Gold free agents coming up in this offseason that need to be re-signed. So let's get it. All right, so first of all, Washington football team re-signed center Chase Roullier to a four-year extension, and it's worth $40.5 million with $19 million guaranteed. Great, great move from this front office. You can already tell they're trying to put together their offensive line for the future for whatever quarterback we end up drafting or bringing in through free agency. You got to remember, Kyle Smith doing this thing. Roullier was a former sixth-round pick. And has started 52 games in four seasons, very dependable. But he's played a total of 58 games. And he became the full-time starter as of 2018. And he has started in every game since that he's played in and has only missed three games since that 2018 season when he started. And he's the center on an offensive line that is eighth in rushing touchdowns. And again, man, he was a sixth round pick, 199th overall, 198 players taken before him in that 2017 draft. And Ron Rivera loves him. He said, Chase has been a steady presence and a leader on our offensive line all season. He is a great teammate and does everything the right way. That's what you need. You need more guys like that in your building. He also said, we are glad to be able to reward a player who has spent his entire career here. He is well deserving of an extension, and I look forward to continuing to coach him as we work towards sustained success here in Washington. Two big things I took from that. He's going to reward guys that want to be here their entire careers. He wants to keep people here. So it sounds like we're going to have more Daryl Greens, guys that have drafted here, stay here throughout their entire career. I'm hoping that continues with Terry McLaurin and Chase Young, Montez Sweat, and all of those guys, Jonathan Allen, and hopefully our future quarterback. And also, he says sustained success here in Washington. He doesn't want just the flash in a pan, 1 year Super Bowl push. He wants sustained success like how I want, like how the Seahawks have been consistently good for years, how the Patriots were consistently great for years, how the Packers are always in the mix. He wants to be one of those teams that's always in the mix year in and year out for at least the next 10 years, and I love that. That's what I want too. But back to Chase Roullier, man. First of all, his Pro Football Focus grades since being drafted have improved every year mightily. 2017, he was 28th out of all centers in the league. 2018, he was 20th. 2019, he was 15th. And this year so far, he's 4th. He's a top 5 center according to Pro Football Focus. And again, you always have to take Pro Football Focus grades with a grain of salt. But at the very least, Chase Roullier is a top 7 center in this league. I don't care what y'all say. And again, with Pro Football Focus, they have him graded as the 5th best pass blocking center, the 7th best run blocking center, which makes him 4th overall. Chase Roullier has only allowed 5 sacks over 3,336 offensive snaps. And we've gone against Aaron Donald once or twice already. Fletcher Cox twice a year. So that's big time for a center in this league. And for him to be a top 7 center, arguably the 4th according to Pro Football Focus, he's only the 8th highest paid center in total value and the 10th highest per year. And it's only going to look better and better as we go along. Because 3 years from now, he's probably going to be somewhere in the 20s of highest paid centers and will still probably at least be a top 7 center. So that's great value per dollar right there. Because right now, he's the 8th highest paid center total with $40.5 million, 10th in annual average per year with $10.125 million, and he's 10th in guaranteed with $19 million. And again, this time in 2022, all of those numbers are going to go up. He's probably going to be like 11th in total, maybe like 12th or 13th in annual, but he's still going to be giving you top 7 talent and production. Excellent contract situation. This is how you have sustained success in the NFL. And also, since we extended him, some of his cap hits this season, which we're not really using it for anything special anyway. So that, again, that's another smart move by the front office. And just in case if you're wondering, with this 10.125 annual money, we still have plenty enough cap room to get Brandon Sheriff signed long term also. And now we have a really good interior offensive line. People keep sleeping on it. Wes Schweitzer, balling. Roullier signed long term, balling. And we just got to get Brandon Sheriff up. Because if you really think about it, the entire offensive line, in my opinion, is at least top half of the league. I think top 15, the way they've been playing ever since after that Rams game when we finally benched Wes Martin. We got Brandon Sheriff back, and Cornelius Lucas has started over Jerron Christian. Since we've had this Lucas, Schweitzer, Roulier, Sheriff, and Moses lineup, we've had a top half of the league offensive line. A lot of people don't exactly know how good our offensive line has actually been. And the best part is we have Lucas signed through 2022 for only $5.3 million total. We have Wes Schweitzer signed through 2023 for only $13.5 million total. We have Roulier on this smart deal, $10 million a year. That's going to look like pennies within 2 years. Moses is signed on a team-friendly deal all the way through 2023. So now we just need to get Brandon Sheriff re-signed. And in worst-case scenario, you get a high-end comp pick, but I prefer to re-sign Brandon Sheriff to some good money and have a top half of the league offensive line at the very least. You go into the 2021 regular season with this offensive line, I'm happy. Of course, Sadiq Charles being added to the mix, he's very talented, has the potential to be a Pro Bowl offensive lineman, so he's going to be in the mix and competing. Then you never know if Kyle Smith finds another gem late in the draft, or him and Ron Rivera find a gem in the free agency like they did with Lucas and Schweitzer. I just love how smart we're being. Chase Roulier, sixth round pick, Wes Schweitzer and Cornelius Lucas, very cheap free agency pickups for relatively medium to long term. Beautiful, beautiful. This is how you win championships right here. Paying guys less money than the production that they're giving you. All these guys are on fairly cheap deals, which opens up the possibility of giving big money elsewhere. That's why I prefer to draft a quarterback. You have them in the first round with that fifth-year option. Now you have a five-year window of your quarterback giving you high production and also making cheap money. And you just have money to spend anywhere else you want to. If you want to go get an Anthony Harris or Justin Simmons at free safety. If you want to go get Allen Robinson at receiver. If you want to go get an elite linebacker in free agency. You have the money to do that. Even if you want to go get Joe Thuney at left guard and make Wes Schweitzer the best backup guard in the entire NFL. And then Brandon Sheriff is due to miss five games a season. So now you have Wes Schweitzer to plug in at right guard whenever necessary, and your offensive line is still top 10 in the NFL, even with Brandon Sheriff hurt. I just don't see how you can mess that up. That just sounds like Super Bowl contender to me. But that's enough of the offensive line. Let's go ahead and move to these other free agents whose contracts are coming up at the end of this season. You have Brandon Sheriff, of course, like we've discussed. And SpotTrack predicts that he'll only cost less than $12 million a year, which is crazy because I thought he'd probably cost up to $15, $16 million a year. But I guess with his injuries adding up and him missing games from time to time, maybe his market value has gone down, his estimated market value. So if you can re-sign Brandon Sheriff for even $13 million a year, you got to. You have to. Like today, go ahead and do that right now. The fact that his estimated market value is $11.1 million is very shocking to me. And if that's true, you do that today. Burgundy and gold today, right now, right behind the Chase Roulier deal. Chase Roulier is more consistent, but Brandon Sheriff is obviously more talented, and when he's at his best, he's definitely better than Chase Roulier, obviously. Then there's also Ryan Kerrigan, where, I mean, I'm down with re-signing him as long as it's a very cheap deal, like I've been saying before the offseason, like I've been saying since the offseason. Thomas Davis, he's retiring. Kevin Pierre-Lewis definitely re-signed him for the next 3 years for something cheap. He's a pretty decent linebacker. Right now, Cole Holcomb's the best linebacker on roster. We still need another linebacker to be great on this team. John Bostic, I feel like, is a backup at best. And Sean Dion Hamilton, who I thought would be really good, has disappeared. So we need another linebacker in the mix with Cole Holcomb and Kevin Pierre-Lewis. Re-sign Kevin Pierre-Lewis to a nice little cheap deal. Ronald Darby also balling. Not sure if y'all know, but Ronald Darby leads the NFL with 19 forced incompletions this year. He's balling, period. With elite free safety help over the top, he could probably play like a Pro Bowler because his biggest weakness is just getting beat deep. He's just not a good backpedaler. But as long as things stay in front of him, he's balling, period. He's locking up. And even some plays, when he's gotten kind of beat deep, he's been able to recover from it and make a play on the ball. So, again, you get him an elite free safety, it's over with. But you got to re-sign Ronald Darby. I already see that happening. There's no way they let him go after he revived his career here like that. We're not going to pull an Eric Flowers with that one. Then Dustin Hopkins. I mean, if we can't find somebody else, you kind of have to. It's not easy to just find another kicker on the street, but at the same time, I do want to bring somebody else to at least compete with them. But definitely don't give Dustin Hopkins Greg the Leg money. Now, Reuben Foster, we're going to have to monitor the situation. I say, but who knows if he'll ever come back healthy. So this is just one that you're going to have to evaluate him at the end of the season and see where he's really at. T. tackle Davis Sharp. I don't know. I mean, he wasn't terrible when he filled in. He wasn't good either. It was a clear downgrade from Cornelius Lucas. I mean, Cornelius Lucas was at left tackle, and then Morgan Moses would move to left tackle in his place, and Davis Sharp played right tackle. And, I mean, of course it was a pretty big downgrade, but it wasn't terrible. So if you can get him on an extremely cheap deal, why not? Ryan Anderson, I think he's gone. I don't even think they're going to bother with him anymore. Nick Sumberg got to. Long snappers that dependable don't come by often. Lamar Miller, we'll see. I think they said Lamar Miller may have some sort of an impact in his last game of the season against the Eagles. So check him out, see where he's at. And if you can, sign him to a 2-3 year cheap deal just to have him around. I think he has a higher ceiling than a Peyton Barber. So, hey, I say keep him around. Michael Kendricks was a good pickup. I'm interested in seeing what he looks like. I hope we give him enough playing time against the Eagles so we get a good evaluation on him, because he used to be a really good linebacker, but we were able to just get him off the couch for a reason. So we have to evaluate him. Jared Norris will also be a free agent, the outside linebacker. We'll have to see on him. Fabian Moreau, corner. I'm definitely down to extend him for something cheap. He still has talent, just needs to hone into it and get the right opportunities. Robert Foster, man. Kyle Allen. I mean, after the way Taylor Heinicke played, I don't know, man. I definitely like Taylor Heinicke more. I like his potential more. Less starts, but he's been in the league longer, and it looked like it when he played. Literally, that fourth quarter he gave us was the best singular quarter of quarterback play we've seen all season from any quarterback on this team. So, I mean, hey, if you can get Kyle Allen, bring him back to see what he can do during training camp, because I think he is a pretty good backup, but Taylor Heinicke looks better. I mean, he looks more mobile. He looks like a better decision maker. And again, it's a very small sample size, but hey, man. Jeremy Sprinkle, tight end. Another one where very cheap if you can, because right now he is tight end too. You don't want to lose your second best tight end, even though he isn't that good. And it's a big drop off from Logan Thomas to Jeremy Sprinkle. You still don't want to lose your second tight end. And who knows what's going on with Thaddeus Moss. Then you have Danny Johnson at corner, who's a restricted free agent. So we'll see how that goes. Cam Sims, definitely re-sign him. He shows flashes. He hasn't been able to be consistent, but hey, bring him back. He does a little something here and there. Definitely make sure he's really cheap, though. And it's funny, too, because Jay Gruden is technically in our 2021 free agents list as a coach. I guess we're still technically paying him as of right now. But yeah, man, that's it, man. I appreciate the view. Please like this video if you liked it. If you learned anything, please get in the comment section and let me know how you feel about the Chase Roullier re-signing. And also, out of this free agency list I just went through, who you feel like the Burgundy and Gold need to re-sign this offseason. And of course, man, make sure you subscribe for more content like this. Hit the bell next to the subscription button so you get a notification every time I release a video like this, every time I come out with a live stream, every time I come out with a film session. All of that. And as always, man, I really appreciate all the support I'm always getting, man. Everybody that donates to the channel, everybody that likes the streams up, the videos up, everybody that's a sponsor, especially the Pro Bowl sponsors whose names you see scrolling on the screen right now. I really appreciate y'all, man. For real, for real. I'll catch y'all later. See y'all tomorrow during the game. 8 p.m. live stream as always, man. I'm out.